Well, I started martial arts when I was 15 with kickboxing. Later on, I went to Porto in university, and there I stopped because I was studying, and then I started Hapkido. Later on, I started boxing and kickboxing again. In the middle, I did some kung fu, did some tai chi. I even tried for 6 months capoeira. Then I also enrolled in wrestling. I did the wrestling coach along with a friend of mine. We founded the club. The club still exists. I was there for 3 years. So I was a little bit here and there. But my main focus was in kickboxing, boxing, and Hapkido. Then I started in 2002. I started with Filipino martial arts, which till now is the thing I do. What I recall is the sticks. I think first thing we did was single stick, and then double stick, I think, yeah. And what I liked was the dynamic. In those days, this is very dynamic, this is very straight to the point. There is no, it is what it is, you see? There is no if this, if that, no. This is what it is. That was my thought back in the day. Oh, this is very practical. And having a stick in the hand is something, maybe it comes from my childhood, I don't know. Because I was raised in a small place, in a small village with 600 people. And I still have pictures of me as a boy always using a stick in my hand. Because that's the way we play with each other. Or alone eating trees or eating branches or eating something. Or playing, you know, in those times the movies of Errol Flynn, I remember Zorro. This kind of characters that use weapons, you see. And later came the kung fu movies that were more empty-handed. But I still recall in my mind that the first notion of a fighter, let's say, was either with guns, the westerns, either with swords, these classics, Errol Flynn, the pirates, and you know, lots of. I think now that I'm talking to you, I'm recalling this.